Swenson here from 89.3 The Current and the host of The Local Show. And today we are going to take a behind the scenes tour at First Avenue. There's a lot of people coming into town for the Super Bowl. A lot of people wondering about this institution in our music scene. And we're going to take a really close look with the legendary photographer.
Oh, thank you so
Dan
much.
Corrigan,
oh my God.
Leading us through. Dan, you do a lot of things here at First Ave. What is your job here?
Well, I'm a in Chris Rabenschneider's new book, I think that description is three paragraphs long. So I do a lot of things here. I started out as the house photographer, and that's kind of what I was famous for. But I worked for Conrad as a stagehand for almost 10 years. And then I've been working facilities now for going on 6 years. So I basically take care of the place. Part of my job is doing the tours here, which I love.
Yes.
Because part of my job is also cleaning vomit off the front of the building. But I love giving tours. And we have a lot of people in town right now and a lot of interest. I mean, just since Prince passed away, we've had an incredible amount of interest in the building. And we have people from around the world come. And so we've started to do a little more formal sort of tour, and that's part of my job as well. And like I say, it's my favorite part of my job. So here we are at First Avenue, and it's super nice to have you all here. First Avenue started out in 1937 as a Greyhound bus station. So, and at the time, it was one of the gems in the Greyhound crown. It really was pretty fancy. It has this sort of Art Deco design with the round features, and it was originally blue. This is actually the blue you see here as a trademark color, Greyhound blue. And the entire building was that blue color. The sidewalks were originally glazed the same blue. I wish I could have seen that because I bet it was really incredible. The Stars came along in about 1990, and this is the second version of the Stars. We had to repaint the building about 12 years ago. And repaint all the new Stars with Prince in an obviously important spot. Prince and First Avenue will always be hooked together, and it, because of Purple Rain, obviously. But Prince didn't make First Avenue. I think it works both ways. I think First Avenue definitely helped Prince. I think one of the reasons why he chose First Avenue to do the live entertainment, the live music scene for Purple Rain, is just it is a beautiful, beautiful room. It's a special room. For the size of the club, because we can fit 1,650 people in here, for the size of the room, it is very intimate. And I think when you're standing on the front of the stage, looking out, if the lighting is right, you can see the face of every single person in the room. So this is an interesting piece of memorabilia. The mixing boards with all the knobs on and whatnot. But what they do is they take a strip of tape and they lay it along the whole thing, and then they use a little Sharpie to mark which each channel is. And there happens to be one from Prince here. So somebody who knows Prince better than I do recognize the lineup as the Sign of the Times tour, which I found out after the fact that Prince actually rented the room for 3 days to rehearse for that tour before he left. So that's almost for sure where this board tape came from. And these are all set lists. These are mostly from the late 90s, early 2000s. They get taken and put up and down. This is kind of interesting. This is the night the ceiling collapsed. This is the last show in the old main room.
Were you here?
I was not here when it happened, but I was here for 80 hours the following week.
Oh my gosh.
I know. So this is kind of interesting. This is one of my, we saved the set lists. And so this is, I started doing that when I was working as a stagehand, so we've been doing that for a long time. I have a huge box upstairs of set lists.
How do you choose which ones go on the wall?
We've kind of run out of room, and so people still sometimes put their own up, and if it stays up, it stays up. This isn't as curated as tightly as it maybe should be, but I love it back there. The thing that's so cool about First Avenue is that we've been doing this for a long time. This is a beautiful spot. And the people that come in through the garage are as much our customers as the people that come in through the front door. And I love the people that come in through the garage. When they come in, they have some sort of idea of the performance, just something, you know, something that they want to do. And I love that if everything works out right, can become something huge, way bigger than just this room, way bigger than just the band, bigger than the audience, something big happens. And I love seeing that happen. And I love that that potential is here every time the garage door opens in the morning. The green room wasn't green until probably 6 years ago. It was just black like everything else. And the higher ups decided that we should make it a little friendlier and a little more professional. And it was Nate's idea to put, these are my photographs from over the years. Nate, our general manager, thought it would be a good idea to put these in here to just help instill a feeling amongst the artists when they're waiting to go on the stage of what's come before them, you know.
Absolutely.
And that isn't always glamorous. Like there's this picture here of the sparsely attended, there's a key over here, you have to look at the name. But I mean, it isn't every night isn't a sold out show, you know.
Right.
So, and it isn't always very glamorous, you know, and it isn't always very exciting.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, the magic can happen, you
right.
know. So it's like, go out and try your hardest, guys.
Right.
Promise not to fall off, which has happened. We had a show here where the headlining act came out and the guy was so psyched, and we had monitors across the front of the stage. I can't remember the name of the band. I maybe will before we're done. But he came out and he put his leg on the monitor like this to sing, like a heroic pose, and rolled right off the front into the barricade pit, broke his leg, compound fracture, show over.
Oh no.
We're right now, we have to do something about the stage because it's kind of, it's age, it gets used a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're talking right now about what we're going to do. And part of that is how do we keep that sort of historic, like, greatness of it, while at the same time keeping it so it's, you know, actually still keeps on working.
Right.
This owner's is the box. Owner's box and tech booth. when Prince visited the club, which he did fairly regularly to come to see music, this was his chair, and he always got that chair.
Aww.
And it was kind of, we were talking about how small he was. Usually when he visited, there'd be like a big bodyguard behind him, sometimes two, and then usually a beautiful woman on his arm, sometimes two. But when he was sitting here, he's so small. It was really incredible. I remember you'd see this little head up, kind of sitting up here. But it was always a special night when
yeah.
he was here. I mean, it was very cool.
Yeah. I like this reserve for the box.
Well, this is Byron, who is the owner. He was the owner. It's his daughter now owns it. And the boss is Shirley, Byron's wife.
Ah.
So that's, I think, what's going on there.
I like that.
Yep. So, and then this is the lighting booth, and the DJ sits up here, and our VJ. So, and this is actually, when I shoot the shows, this is my seat. I have,
aww.
Like, I swear, the best seat in the house. This is just,
yeah,
this is my favorite place to shoot from, because I'm not in anybody's way, and I have a good view.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed it. This has been a very behind-the-scenes look at First Avenue with the legendary photographer,
oh my gosh.
Dan Corrigan.
Oh, thank you so much. Nice to have you here.